explanation. It's made of two words actually, Jalod and Bast. Jalod comes from Jalod Bhav, a demon. He was living in Kashmir Lake. Most of the people must be knowing this demon grew up to kill people. And then Kashyap Rishi was requested, and all the story about that, Jalod Bhav was killed, and then people again could live there. This story translates today to our times. This Jalod Bhav is still living around. It's in everybody's septic tank. It lives in the manhole. It lives in the leech pit. It may be living at so many other places where ultimately some man gets affected. I wouldn't venture saying to the level of death, but otherwise also infecting people, making them sick, and shaking our very souls. So Jalod Bast is that machine which will bust this Jalod Bhav at every place that it is still existing at. Manual scavenging has a very old history. The first time man thought of being civilized was he will part ways of defecating from the animals. Now he will go into a private space for this important, urgent and essential task. And that is, we also see the first trace of civilization in Indus Valley civilization 5,000 to 7,000 years back, because we see a toilet there. But this first step was not complete, because one man had to clean after. Who that man was, who that person was, the story kept on moving down the time till recently, as we can say, in Mughal period, it was continuing. The first time we saw the conscious speaking out for this was by Mahatma Gandhi in 1936 in Sevagram. Perhaps he did not find any solution to complete this first step of civilization, that he asked his people that you should clean after yourselves, since we have not found any solution to this. Down from that time till recently, people must have watched the movie Toilet Ek Prem Katha. The struggle there is again the same. Who will clean after me? If I have a toilet in my place, am I pushing another man down? That was the struggle. And the struggle is continuing till today. I believe every individual is shaken to the core when he sees a picture. Some family is affected, some individual is getting killed. And he, at the core of his heart, knows he is part of the problem. Everyone of us, if he is not on the other side, on the side of the solution, is definitely on the side of the problem. And now I believe the time has come when this problem has to be put to rest. For all times to come, the civilization has to complete this first step towards being civilized. Kindly have a look at this. This is the problem at the bottom of manual scavenging. The sludge is left behind by the existing systems. They are able to remove the liquid, the semi-liquid, but the settled solids, which over years settle, harden, they remain there. Over a couple of cycles, maybe 5 to 10 years later, a man is needed to go inside and clear this. That is the starting point of manual scavenging. The same story is repeated in septic tanks. It is repeated in maybe STP somewhere, maybe inside a manhole. This is the same thing happening again and again. This is the same place which is causing the manual scavenger to come in. So we started by breaking this sludge and trying to move it out. And this is where the solution is. We have used a problem which hydropower engineers face all their life, that is the hydraulic shockwave. I have used hydraulic shockwave to our advantage. Perhaps the first time hydraulic shockwave is now coming to our rescue. Myself, Rakesh, I am a civil engineer at core. Some more my education added. I have studied in NIT Srinagar, 85 or so. Then I worked for 21 years in the government. The government people can relate to me. This was the best time when I could do social service without worrying for my piece of bread. And I could have collected karma for the next 10 genomes. Then I moved over to the private sector. Private sector people can relate to me. But there was something more to be done. And then I have entered this phase. My people are helping me. Hello Science Denmark was the first one to identify and support this idea. Presently, I'm being supported by Social Alpha. All through, they have been my support. They have seen to it. Now we are in the product development phase. This basic model has been, a couple of them we made, we sent it out to the people. These people have finally approved it, and now our partner, he is educating other people, informing them how it is useful. The problem is solved, we see so many times, but the last mile problem, is it going inside the lane? Is the last village, last toilet being attended? What is left out? We are trying to do that. We will be assisting all other technologies, all other people who are out there. And its application has to be in different forms. The smallest one will be Jalod Bus Pride. It is going to be a small portable device, maybe 30 kgs, where this man, wherever he goes, he will be carrying this. Instead of this man touching anything, this machine will do the task. Now, this has to be a complete comprehensive solution. One, we have made it into an entrepreneur model where one individual will be able to earn 30,000 per month out of this, based on 3,000 to 5,000 households, whether it's a big village or it's a couple of villages, a suburb. And I remember one story. I would like to connect it to one story, that is the pulse polio. When I was a kid, I was administered polio drops. But still the polio drops are being spread out, being given to the kids. Because somewhere, anywhere in the corner of this world, if the virus is still there, we are not safe. Same way, if any point, any place in geography, across the country, across the globe, somebody is doing this manual scavenging, we can't say that we have risen that one first basic notch in civilization, which was started by our ancestors maybe 7,000 years before. This is the time when all of us should join our hands together, see to it that this technology reaches out to everybody, and every manual scavenger drops down his pail and he becomes the entrepreneur or anybody else. This profession becomes caste free, this profession becomes community free, and it is as good as somebody driving a cab or being an operator. And that is the place, that is the point when manual scavenging will be finished off, and it will be an essential task being done as an essential task should be done as an operator. Thank you very much.